opportunity to introduce you all to all of our senior fine arts, specifically theater seniors, and just kind of showcase all the things that they've been doing in their time here at Ascension.
This is our wonderful senior, Lauren Frankes. We're so excited to be speaking with you today, Lauren. For those of you who don't know, would you tell us what role you were going to play in Sound of Music?
I would have been Louisa, which is the 13-year-old kid of Captain Von Trapp.
Now, you're a senior, which means you're probably 18.
I'm 17. I'm almost 18.
Almost 18. And that you got cast as a 13-year-old. How is that even possible?
Well, I'm a full 5 feet, so that probably helps. And I just look young.
And you have a sweet, sweet demeanor.
Oh, thank you.
So, Lauren, we know that you're not a stranger to the stage. You've done some other musicals. You've never done a straight show, but tell us about the other musicals you've done.
My freshman year, I was in Addams Family, which was so much fun. I was just an ancestor ghost in the ensemble, but I loved it so much that I knew I wanted to do it again. So I came back next year for Phantom of the Opera. That was absolutely life-changing. It was very cool just to be a part of something so much bigger than myself. And then I had to take a break junior year because of changing show times. But I came back senior year.
Lauren, tell us, what was your favorite Sound of Music memory?
I would definitely say just hanging out with all the other little kids. Not little kids. They're not little. They're just kids. I was obviously cast as a kid, so I got to hang out with a lot of the middle schoolers who were able to be in the production. And I actually really bonded with them, and they were so sweet. And it was part of my favorite, like, one of my favorite part of the day.
When you cast somebody who's not only talented, as you are, but also is a leader, it's a double whammy. I have to say, it was so fun seeing how, you can say the little kids, because we had, this show was 6 through 12, so we did have some younger kids. And in fact, we had a couple even younger kids than sixth grade. Didn't we, Miss McDonald?
Yep, we had a third grader.
And they clung to you. They clung to everybody, but they went right for you, because I think you have such a wonderfully nurturing spirit. It does break my heart that this was our big role that we had for you, and we didn't get an opportunity for you to perform. But my hope is if you get a chance to audition again for Sound of Music, you may consider doing it.
I would love that. It is one of my favorite shows.
Any particular anecdote that you would care to share? A funny story maybe about a fellow senior or anything like that that was thought about?
So me and Emma Gotro became really good friends during Phantom, actually. And her and Lily, my sister, was in the production too. And we had different dressing rooms, but they would come up to me in between times when, like, we were both off stage, and they would tell me about all the ghosts that, like, they had seen. They were going ghost hunting in the opera house.
Thank you for all of your work, Lauren. I think I can speak for the team and say that we were always really impressed with what you brought to the stage, especially considering, like you said, it was one of your first bigger roles. And the fact that you were in character all the time, and you made some really great choices. And it was just the subtleties in your expression and your movement and the way you just kind of embraced the other kids on and off the stage that really made it special.
I think I'm correct in saying this would have been your first and last show you have ever done at Ascension, is that right?
Yes, it would have been right.
Now, tell us a little bit how and why you came out for Sound of Music your senior year.
I came out for Sound of Music my senior year because I lost a bet in a fantasy football league.
Lost a bet in I'm sorry to hear that.
So being this was your first role and your first theater experience, can you think of, like, just any fond memory that you have either of rehearsals or the show?
My first rehearsal I showed up to after basketball season ended, I think it was. And I showed up late and everybody was already reading scripts, trying to learn the play. and we ended up going play a game to help with teamwork.
Was the, with the experience you had in the show, was it different than what you thought? Was it more difficult? Was it easier? Did you think, what were your impressions?
It was much more difficult than I thought it would be. Just seeing how much everyone had to work. If it wasn't me specifically working a lot, it was just like seeing all the effort put in by y'all and the other cast members.
So one last question, I think. If you had to do it all over again, like if you were given the option to audition for a show, or if you had future theater opportunities to come along, do you think you would audition to be in another show?
Probably not.
I was pleasantly surprised when I saw you show up for audition. What led you to audition for this show?
My friend told me about the show. He was like, oh, Elliot, you should definitely join Sound of Music. I thought on whether if I should do it or not, and I was like, you know what, why don't I give it a try?
Well, I'm so glad you did, and I'm hopefully your friend got the money I paid him to get you to come out and audition for this show. Was there anything that you saw that went above your expectation? Was it harder than you thought? Was it easier? Was it more challenging?
Getting a speaking role got above my expectations. I just expected to be like an extra or something like that. Getting a speaking role, I'm just amazed by that. At first, it was like hard to get used to since like I've never done anything like performing arts wise. As I went into the practices and all, I just started getting more and more used to it and started getting the feeling of it, you know?
We were happy to have you in the production. We're all really disappointed that we weren't able to see you on stage as well as all of your peers, but we're so grateful for your hard work.
I was so impressed with how seriously you took the whole process. You stepped right in, you weren't intimidated. You took your role seriously, and I really appreciated seeing what you did.
Thank y'all so much. It was a blessing to be part of Sound of Music.
Emily, we didn't get a chance to do the show, as you know, sniffle, sniffle, but you were a part of the rehearsal process, and you've been a part of many rehearsal processes. How many shows have you done at Ascension?
If you include Sound of Music, this would have been my third show.
Every time we have you on stage, you bring a powerful performance, and we're so thankful for that. Tell us, though, what was your favorite part of this rehearsal process?
I got put in a role that was a little bit outside of my regular comfort zone. And I think this rehearsal process gave me a lot of chance to grow, not just in like the theater aspect, but in just like confidence in myself.
You were definitely a leader throughout this process. And I've seen you have to kind of carry some scenes with
Lauren. Can you hang up, buddy?
What? She put in a thing and I just joined.
I know, don't join.
One of my favorite memories happened a little behind the scenes where we asked Miss McClymont to go get ice cream at rehearsal because it had kind of been a stressful day. And although that didn't happen, the next rehearsal, sitting in my classroom with a couple of the cast members eating Mickey-shaped ice cream and just kind of kicking the rehearsal off that way. But so thank you for, again, being a leader throughout the process and keeping everyone on track and encouraged and making the best of the entire thing.
Absolutely. I definitely echo that. Emily, you are a superstar in my book, and I was so thankful to work with you during Importance of Being Earnest. You did a fantastic job, and I was so sorry that we didn't get to see you officially perform this, but the energy and dedication and commitment you brought to the rehearsal process was truly spectacular. So thank you, Emily. We're here with Todd Dore, senior theater extraordinaire. Todd, let's start off first. What role were you playing in Sound of Music?
I was Max in Sound of Music. I think one of the funniest things that we ever did in rehearsal was doing the scene where Max was playing with the kids and singing the Goat Herd song with them.
Yeah.
Blindfold. It was awkward at first, but then it became like fun and funny, and like I would mess around with the people who were playing the Von Trapp kids. And I found that very funny.
What's been your favorite show that you've done at Ascension so far?
This would have to be Max and Sound of Music.
It's been great watching you blossom in that role. I know at the beginning you kind of expressed that you weren't necessarily used to playing this type of character, and it was a little bit tough, but watching you grow and really take ownership of that role and create such a believable character and add your own flair to it has been really enjoyable, and it's definitely sad that we don't get to see you bring that character to life on stage.
God, where are you heading off to? Tell the audience what you're doing next year.
I am going to be majoring in popular and commercial music with a concentration in voice at Loyola University.
Wow. That's exciting. Well, you never know what happens in life, and I hope for your sake that you get to reprise the role of Max someday, maybe in community or regional theater.
Yeah, me too.
It has been a joy to see you grow as a performer. I personally enjoyed watching you in Faith County. I have that great memory of being on headset in Faith County and hearing "The Piano Is Not on the Stage."
Oh my God. Remind
me. Oh, that was a great, great funny part where the piano was supposed to be on the stage. And of course, it was crucial because Emery was going to have to play it. And here we are in the middle of the play, and we have to figure out how to bring a 200-pound piano, which doesn't roll well at all. Anyway, besides that, you did a great job in that show, and I think it really spoke. It was a testament to your professionalism because, again, it's not a huge role, but with it, you did a great job really bringing that character to life. So I want to just say congratulations, and I hope you come back and visit us.
We are here with senior extraordinaire Stephen Lupus. So, Stephen, tell us your role.
I was slated to play Baron Elberfeld.
Stephen, how many shows have you done at Ascension?
All five of the musicals.
Wow.
And then I was an understudy in Lost in Yonkers. And then I was the Merryman in The Importance of Being Earnest.
So, Stephen, of all those shows you've done at Ascension, any favorites that stick out?
Grease, actually, the first one. I got my own solo.
How was it? Were you nervous when you did that?
I wouldn't say too nervous.
Stephen, how has theater at Ascension helped shape you, not so much on stage, but maybe for your future major or college or maybe just as an individual?
Yeah, I think maybe I'm more expressive, better talking to people. But also, like, a really close friend of mine transferred between 7th and 8th grade, so those theater people kind of became my new friends.
Well, that's great. And I have to say, personally, Stephen, I've seen a load of growth from you from the Grease days until now, not just your stage presence, but your leadership too.
So do you have a specific memory or moment from The Sound of Music that you would like to share?
The first thing that comes to mind is like bringing the cane I got from Old Vogue. I still haven't returned that thing. It's like a month late. I think they're, like, I feel bad, but at the same time, I don't think they're operating at the moment, so I don't know how I'd get it back to them.
I don't think we knew that was even a part of your costume or character. It just,
I love that. Character choices.
Yeah, some really strong choices.
That was awesome. Well, I think that highlights having Stephen in a role at Ascension. You brought such joy to the cast, no matter what size role you had. I think everybody enjoyed having you in the show and hearing your insight. And also having you in theater. You took theater class for 4 years at Ascension. Yep. And there are very few people who do that. And so having you do that was, again, a testament to your dedication to not only theater, but I think just growing as an artist too. So, Stephen, I just want to say congratulations and thank you so much for all you've done for the theater department at Ascension.
It's been a great run.
What role were you going to play in Sound of Music?
Sister Margaretta.
How many shows have you done with Ascension?
I've done 3, but I played in the pit for Freaky Friday, which was super fun.
Any favorite memories of any of the shows?
Definitely just like hanging out backstage. And I had some like really cool, like, I don't know, during Phantom, we had some fun sets that were always like crazy to move. That was always like a super fun thing to do. So
give us your favorite memory of Sound of Music, even though we didn't get a chance to perform.
Definitely just like hanging out with the Duns and Emily Brown backstage, just hanging.
Emma, it's always been a joy seeing you, even in the few roles that you have done here at Ascension. And what I love the most about you, just as a performer in general and not necessarily on the stage, is the fact that you're so versatile, and being that you are a musician and you have a very strong ear. And so I feel like you're definitely an anchor when it comes to helping to lead the way in a lot of these vocal parts. And so I thought it was great to see you go from the stage to the pit, especially, you know, with your time in Freaky Friday. And that's an experience that not a lot of people can say. So thank you for always putting in so much work. And I know sometimes we can be hard on you guys, and you just always rose to the occasion and had that same smile every single time in rehearsals. So thanks for all that you've done. And we're sad that we couldn't go on with the show, but we know that you guys would have done great work. How many shows have you been involved in?
I think my first show was Pinocchio, and I was in seventh grade, and I've done a show every year since then. So a good bit, like six, I think. Phantom of the Opera was probably my favorite, but Importance of Being Earnest was a close second, because that was really fun just because the cast is really small. But Phantom was just a really hard show, and no one really expected it to happen, but we all pulled it off, and it was just a really fun show.
Not to say you didn't stand out in all your shows, especially Pinocchio. It was Freaky Friday, if I can suggest this, is that where everyone went, whoa, hello, Emily Brown. She can sing. She's a really good performer. Did you feel that at all during Freaky Friday?
Yes. I remember, like, after the show, like, people came up to me and they were like, I didn't know you could sing like that. And I was like, you know, because I've been singing forever, but like that was the point where I started singing more. So yeah, it was cool.
One of the things that impresses me so much about you, Emily, is that you take whatever role you're given and you really make it great, that you're committed to it. Not only the homework that you do, lines and working on, again, this wasn't a musical, but when you did do Freaky Friday, you really worked hard on that and mastering that role. But also with the Importance of Being Earnest, you took what you had and you really made it excellent. And that's something I really appreciate and I will miss dearly about having you a part of the team, is that I think you are such a leader in that respect. Did you have any memories that you'd like to share about Sound of Music?
I just remember, like, sometimes I would like get to rehearsal early, and the people that were early would just like goof off and have fun, and we would like make TikToks, and it was just really funny. And also when the teachers started coming to rehearsal, that was really fun too, to just see them outside of school. So it was cool that we could help them out and, you know, get to talk to them more. So I was going to play Mother Abbess.
You did play Mother Abbess, even though you just didn't get to perform it in an official capacity. I was looking forward to just seeing this part of your face.
I know.
Where are you heading off to next year?
I'm going to LSU, and I got in their honors program, and I'm going to be on the pre-med track.
For those of people out there who have been living under a rock, what role were you going to play in Sound of Music?
I was going to play Maria.
Oh, I am so sad that the world will not see you play that role, because you did such an amazing job. How many shows have you done at Ascension?
I think seven, yes.
Seven roles. And what was your favorite role at Ascension?
All so fun. I loved playing Cecily in The Importance of Being Earnest, though. She'll have to be my favorite.
Okay. So the straight show, because you've done both musicals and straight shows,
yes,
right? And you've taken roles behind the stage too, right?
Yeah, that was my first theater experience. I did sound, so.
Tell us what you're doing next year.
I am attending Viterbo University to pursue a BFA in musical theater.
When in your career did you think, okay, I want to do this at the next level?
I'm going to have to say it was between like my sophomore and junior year. There wasn't a specific time, I've always known that I wanted this to just be in my life forever though. So yeah. My favorite memory is probably my first show, opening night of the Addams Family. That was just something that I had never experienced before, and it was just so amazing to like the opening number was just so rewarding because we had put in all that work, and to hear the audience and their reactions to the big opening number of the Addams Family was just so fun. But as for Sound of Music, I think like the first time we had sung through Do Re Mi was so, it was just so fun. It got me so excited for the rest of the rehearsal process with everyone. They all just are so talented, and it was so fun to work with everyone.
Well, I am so thankful that you were part of our program because you brought a level of maturity and professionalism to all the roles, whether you were on stage or off stage. I could always, and I think I speak for all the directors, we could always rely on you to bring your A game, that you really took the process seriously, and I'm so thankful for that because you're such a an example to everybody else in the program, and you brought the level of the whole program up. So thank you for that. And then as a performer, you're a magnetic. We just couldn't keep our eyes off you. And again, I keep saying this, I'm sorry that the world is not gonna be able to see you as Maria, but watching you in rehearsals and seeing all the choices that you made, it was very special to see you, and I think that role was perfect for you. And I hope sometime in your career, maybe in Wisconsin, you'll get an opportunity to audition for it again, because I think you would be great for it. We'll be right back.